So hi, welcome back to the Raw Projects. Got a busy day ahead of us today, so we're going to be getting into a little bit of swing saw action, a little bit of bucking with the chainsaws, a little bit of splitting, and a fair bit of stacking. Join me. So welcome back to the Raw Projects. Yeah, I'm down here in the woodyard, and it's been a long, long time since I've been back here in the woodyard. Been spending a lot of time down by the dam, but finally all that wood near the dam or above the dam, it's all cleared. Everything I needed to move is moved. I'll show you what that looks like now. Last time I brought this video here, this was full of wood. I've seen there's about four or five trailer loads, and there was four. Right, all this bucked up wood is all gone. The only thing I still have to do down here really is the two trees that came down a couple of weeks ago. Got to get into them at some point. But I will not be getting into those today. That's for another week. I might leave that quite a while, to be honest. Really was keen to just get the work that I'd started here, get that finished. I like to sort of start a job and then get it all done. And then nothing worse than leaving here each time thinking there's a half finished job for when I come back. Right, let's get back up the hill there, get the swing saw out and get that wood cut. So we got a couple of long logs there that were dragged up. I haven't booked those to length yet. Got a big log which dragged up with the excavator just the other day that needs booking to length. As you can see, it's got a bit of a hollow on the end. And then I've got a trailer load of wood, so that's sort of three quarts full of booked logs. And then the rest of it is as you can see, is all these small branches that need to go through the swing saw. My wood pile here is getting bigger and bigger and fuller and fuller. So the plan today is to get the swing saw down here, get all these cut to length, and fill the space there with all that booked wood. And then in this area in front of the wood pile, I'm going to actually build another one of those temporary stores, and create myself some more space for more booked logs. And then when that's done, we'll be getting into a little bit of chainsaw action, booking that one up with the 462. I've got a 36 inch bar ready for the back end of that log because it's pretty meaty. And then we'll book all of these to length as well. So I am hoping by the end of the day we've got this woodyard nice and tidy, all cleared. But I always have lots of ambitions and can't always follow through on them. So let's see how we get going today. Okay, that's it. Heaps of logs, they're all cut to length. So we'll now start the next task. We'll get all these stacked in the wood pile here before we make a start on the next job, which will be building another temporary wood store. Right, let's get these stacked. Thank you. Right, hopefully you can see this area. This area here is still a little bit damp there with the water that comes onto it. So what I'm going to do is put some of the big logs down the bottom and all small stuff on top. Right, that's a good base down now. So we'll get a little bit of time lapse going and you'll see me going into hyperdrive in 3, 2, 1. As you can see, there's a real variety of logs getting put up here. Some of it is extremely dense like this, and other stuff pretty hollow, pretty light. Won't be amazing wood firewood. This stuff will be awesome. That one won't be great, but it's an absolute mix. Something satisfying about stacking rounds. Just seem to end up with a bit of a nicer wood pile, especially a lot of the stuff I split tends to be pretty messed up in shape. It's not like a lot of the straight logs that you see overseas. A lot of the stuff I end up cutting is pretty ugly and twisted. Right, seem to be down to the scraps now. Let's see what else I can scrounge. There's possibly just a couple of handfuls or handfuls left, and then this part of the job for today is done. Soon get into the good stuff. The good stuff being big chainsaws, big logs, lots of noise, sawdust. Right, that is the last small round. What I'm going to do now, go off to the trailer, pull out some of the rounds from over there, stick them on top, and then we'll reassess and see what I've still got left to stack, and then make a start on this temporary wood store. The first ones that I pulled out, these are all hollow. These came off the back of the big log that I'll be booking up later today. Looking at how they'll sit on there, it's going to look a little bit awkward. So what I'm going to do, I'll get the axe out and we'll give these a quick split, and then hopefully they'll stack a little bit neater. State of me. I am filthy from moving all these black logs, all these burnt logs. Right, let's get some of these split down. Tell the difference, this is yellow box. That's got it. Wow. stuff's much harder. That one done. Let's get to stacking. Wood is split and stacked. Okay, it's a nice good jag of wood I've got in here, certainly growing. Still plenty in the trailer to go at, and still a big log to book to length. What I'm going to do now with all the parts of the wood store there, let's get a wood store put in front of this wood store. And yeah, then we've got a space then for all the new stuff to go. Bearing in mind, still have that tree to drag down and book to length, and the two that I mentioned earlier in the video down by the dam. Right, you've seen me build one of these before, so let's get the time lapse going, and hopefully 10-15 minutes this thing will be up. Not even 15 minutes, can't have been more than 5. Right, this is awesome, we've got this built. We'll get the time lapse back on again now, and we will start filling it. Right, let's go. Okay, the only stuff that's left now in a trailer is just scraps. This stuff will go in my cookie pile at the top of the hill. Look at my face here, it's got a lot of muck on it. I get absolutely black when I am moving all this burnt wood around. You just can't help it. Gloves get covered, your clothes get covered. And inadvertently, obviously I wipe my face and it gets covered as well, so. Right, I'm gonna have a quick drink, something to eat, and then I'm gonna get into the bit that's the fun part of the day. Grab the excavator, grab the big chainsaw, get this big log up in the air, and get into some booking heaven. It's a bit of lunch, and I am refreshed and raring to go now. So what I think I'm gonna do, I'll get the chainsaw fired up. We'll make a start on the smaller stuff first. Always saving the best to last, which is this nice big piece. Okay, we'll use the MS-362 on the smaller pieces. Let's get the excavator into position, get the bigger one of those pieces, get it picked up, and we'll get it booked to length and stacked. Okay, right, we got that one all booked up now. I'll do a quick stack with that stuff. I'll cut the rest of those small pieces and then we'll get into the big one, which is the one I've been waiting for. Right, bring you back in a few minutes. Big log is in the jaws of the excavator. It's all marked out. I've gone through with a 362 and marked where I need to cut. She's a big old lump. Excavator only just sort of picks it up, really. Right, let's get the 462 warmed up. I want to get into this. This is the highlight of the afternoon for me now.
Thank you.
I don't know if you heard that, but I certainly felt it. I touched the ground there. With, just luckily it's the last cut. I certainly did dull that chain. I could feel it hitting the stones. So this has been cutting well. That to me, those are good chips in this hardwood. Happy, very happy with those. Okay, that's it for today. As you can see, we've got all the wood stacked. We've done a bit of a tidy up down here. So a lot of this wood was stringy back, and anybody who's cut stringy back knows you get an awful lot of mess. So I've just taken away two trolley loads of waste, all the bark that fell off, and obviously a load of waste pieces of wood, the ends, and awful lot of wood chips. Right, I've really enjoyed myself today. This has been an awesome day. A lot of tidy up, a lot of moving wood around here, a lot of cutting, and I've got myself a nice, neat and tidy wood store yet again. Yeah, all the wood is stored behind me, and this is awesome. This is most probably close to all of my wood for next year as well. So all my winter wood is already split and stacked, but this will be wood to split next winter for the following winter. So certainly looking good here. Run out of space though, as you can see. Had to stick all of the big rounds from the big log there, to stick all those on the ground. What I'll do is I'll bring another one of those wood stores down here, and in the future we'll get that wood off the ground as well. What I'm hoping to do is get some sort of roof over all this wood in the future. I'm not sure whether it'll just carry on with the tarpaulin that I've been using or whether I'll use some of the tin sheets, but I'll make a call on that later. But at the moment, as it's starting to warm up now, we're heading into summer, only a few days away from the start of summer, and the weather's warming up. Not too worried about the lid on this. So yeah, it'd be good to get some of the sun on it and get it all dried out. Right, well, I'm going to do a final little bit of tidy up and then call it for today. So thanks for watching. Don't forget, you need to click like and subscribe. Put some comments in the comment section below. This has been a great day for me, and hopefully you've enjoyed the video wherever you are in the world. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time on The Rural Project. Right, and there we have it. Nice close-up of all of the wood. And as I said, there is more to come. Two trees down by the dam that need to be collected, booked and stored. And there's a tree just to my left up the hill near the woodyard here. Needs to be dragged down, booked and stored.